Hello, and welcome back to Mama Saga. See, can we spare some time to waste? I think one day would be enough for us. Just one day. We just need to leave. Several humans and a few rao wander out of the old wood to join. Almost all look dazed, moving by world rather than purpose. Not much different than you and the scant few left in the caravan. Ivar pulls you aside. Look at us, Rook. There's not much to look at, maybe that's what you mean. I couldn't do a damn thing to help. You've never seen the world like this. We all scattered like roaches. I don't know if all the ones missing are dead or just lost. I couldn't tell if we were chasing that serpent or trying to get away from it. And the way Eowyn threw lightning at it. I've never seen anything like that. And I've lived a long damn time. He must have wounded that thing 100 times before it stopped, then blasted open inside to save her. I can't tell if you like what he did or not. What's me liking it or not have to do with anything? He did what he did because he had to. You and me have been in the same situation before and would probably do something similar. We both looked towards Juno and Eowyn. I don't know the first thing about Spellweavers, but I get the feeling he's not an ordinary mender. And a Valka being swallowed by a serpent and put out with lightning? It sounds like one of Alara's tales. How did she live through that? I don't know how any of us... Gibbs moaned. I guess not many of us did live through it. The silence that follows becomes an unavoidable presence. When Juno stands from the cart carrying her, clansmen recall old prayers or pull their children behind them. She takes in their frightened stares with grace, but beckons to Eowyn to join her away from the caravan. The two menders are given privacy, but out of fear more than respect. Ivar shakes his horned head. I'm not sure where all this is leading, but these clansmen, what's left of them, aren't doing so good. I'll speak to the beer families and calm them. While you're doing that, Ivar says, I'll see what I can find out from the menders. Find a few family leaders and do your best to assure them that things will calm down. Waterfalls, marsh towns, horseborn, and giant snakes, one father said. You got no clue what's coming, orders shout their agreements, but he calls for them to be quiet. Neither do any of us, and that's the truth. So we stick to your banner. The others lose the fight in their eyes and nod. Thank you.
There are signs of recent fighting all around Fiskivik. But it might provide a meeting ground for all who scattered when the serpent struck.
Days have passed since Eowyn pulled Juno from the serpent. Though the menders are mostly back to their normal selves, the clansmen continue to keep their distance. I'm not sure I'm still cut out for this. Just a lot of people. You can't prepare for giant snake busting up your camp. But these people depend on me. I gave them my all if we would get to Arboran. Then keep going. From the moment you left Skullgirl, you knew everyone would make it, but the rest of you can. Besides, what else can you do? You'll stay alive, and as long as you do, these people are going to follow you. Keep saying you instead of we. Are you trying to tell me something? The giant voice sighs. Juno and Eowyn. They want me to join them. What? Join them where? They haven't filled me in on most of the plans, but they said I'm needed and that we're leaving the caravan. I'll need to talk to them about this. And here I thought I didn't have a father. Can I go if I finish my chores? A sigh. No doubts whatever they had planned would be dangerous. But sticking with you hasn't really been the safest route either. But we're almost to Aberrang. And then what? The human's capital full of woe and fearing war from the dread. What do you do what you have to do, but that's no place for me. Before you can respond, Junon Aemon arrive. Her whole appearance catches you off guard. If I ever told you of our plans? Well, he could. What's this all about? We are no longer good for the caravan. Our presence not only scares the clansmen, but puts them in real danger. Beyond that, the serpent's attack has clarified our need to move quickly, something we can do with all of you. But this caravan needs the three of you. I need you to help get these people to Aberrang. That's not entirely true. You've been working on something to learn about the Geirangus Ghoststone. That's right. Let me your map. Confused, you hand your map to the Valka. She and Eowyn hold it at corners for tracing patterns with spear and staff. The map glows faintly, and loose threads from her cloak and his tunic snake through the aged material. The image pulses. It looks like. The gods may be dead, but a few of their secrets remain. I've spoken about the darkness enshrouding the land, and now you bear witness to it on your map. The sky will soon reflect the truth shown here. Even the chasm opening across the land are displayed, but your path to Aberrang is clear. Speed will be your ally now. With so few, you should be able to outpace whatever comes your way. I still don't understand why you need Ifer. A wound arm Varl brings good luck. You shake your head but refuse to look at the Varl. Our strength and resolve will be necessary for us in the days ahead. It's the same resolve you use daily, and you will have Hakon and the remaining Varl with you for strength. But Ivor's my friend. Ivor exhales loudly, like his resilient breath has held in for ages. In all my years I've never had another friend than you. I doubt that will change even if I live another century or two, and it sure won't change with distance, understand? Your words come to mind, so simply nod. You and the rest of the caravan are needed in Aberrang. What will assault you there will require every bit of your wits and strength to survive, and even then you will perish if you do not succeed. How will I know if I succeeded? You will know because you'll still be alive. You must get to the capital, you must stay alive, no matter what occurs, hold out as long as you can. Hold on until the darkness breaks. Silence follows her words. You keep saying darkness, but what is it? Juno stares at you, your concern about the darkness starts to fade until Eowyn touches her shoulder. The darkness is a mistake, a part of this world never meant for you or us or anyone alive today. Then why is it here? Because Eowyn... That's enough. The Valka looks at you, and for a moment, her hard-eyed expression cracks. We're trying to do what we have to. Notice her spear moving ever so slightly before your mind moves to other things. What can I expect in Aberrang? I wish I could promise you nothing but safety, but Aberrang will be the refuge for so many. Clans will vie for power the way they always do, even in the face of destruction. Remember, you are Sandro Seller. Your reputation will help you a great deal. That doesn't really put me at ease. Just use what you've learned on this journey and keep the others alive. I should get the clan ready to head up the coast in West Aberrang. If you were anyone else, I'd stick around to help. But there's no one alive better suited to take care of these folks. You look at the giant Varl who has been with you through so much. Do we see each other again, then? Depends on where we're going. I might like it there better than being around you. The dreamy smile. Oh, and Rook, do everyone a favor. Clean yourself up. Peps, you're about to see your king. Looking down at your clothes and hands, you actually have unconceived wound. Be well, Rook. You as well, Eowyn. Ivor and Eowyn find a small fishing skiff. The once clear water of the Fiska Bay is turning green and foul as the war hauls the vessel toward the receding tide. I'm sorry for the hardship that has become your life. Though it probably means little to hear it from me, you've done great work in making it this far. Continue to push hard for the capital. With luck, a small force will face and defeat the darkness before it reaches you. I hope our efforts will not be in vain. Then I hope luck is with you as well. Take care of Ivor. The Valkyr gives you a small smile before following the other two, returning to the caravan. Everyone on your feet! We're pushing to Arborang! Chapter 13. The Fetters Will Burst. Away from the woodcutter camp, where you found rest for the ravens, Volka joins you as you stare into the woods. Don't tell me you're fine with when you're not. You're still having those damn dreams. You growl, feeling less like talking than ever, but knowing the shield made a memory drop. I keep seeing Dredge in different ways. We are eating together, then they are gone. Once I was teaching them to fight and they respected me. It's not me, but it feels like me. Volka watches you, listening closely. In dreams, I feel old, ancient, strong. But then the dread disappear and I feel...
What?
Sad, like an emptiness. Loneliness?
Well, I happen to know all about loneliness among company.
When you don't laugh, she just shrugs it off.
It's just strange that you're feeling kinship to a dread. If you tried talking to a strong singer we picked up?
That would just get the Fae Valka involved.
Zephyr will get involved regardless. If the map's right, we'll hit Old Fort and... be at the Valka Tower in Manahar soon. She'll have plenty to say there, and besides, who else knows anything about that darkness about to swallow us up?
You're right, I'll talk to her about the dreams.
Good, you're losing sleep, that puts us all in danger.
You hold up your hand, sensing something amiss. Volka and you both scan the trees.
There!
You point to an archer losing her arrow and dodge it, roaring a battle cry.
Give us your food and your weapons!
You're trying to rob us? They won't live to learn their mistake.
This makes it better.
Oh, I think it will be somewhere here. would use the wolf. Wait, what hit him previously then? One of the attackers is trying to hold Gera a wound across his stomach. He whimpers as he approaches. Who sent you? Growl. We escaped. They left forever. Left us in Gaular. Prisoners. No food. You are starving. He ended his life quickly before returning to Camp of Volcan. You find the varl near an empty barrel, staring at the darkness. He would be drunk if there was more meat for him. What is this, it we were doing, Bloodax? I mean, honestly, what's the plan roughing around in the head of yours?
I'm trying to keep us alive.
And you don't find that strange? A varl berserk playing dead mother to a bunch of humans? Getting seen Bloom's face before the ground.
Maybe you've outlived. You're welcome here.
Save your show of strength for one of your pups here who should be intimidated. Grab the warhawk by a horn and punch him in the gut. The dog was over. Coughing. The red-headed warhawk grunts, rearing up with a punch that catches you in the chin. While you recover, the ravens all gather around, some daring to cheer, Volca waters with interest. Try to wrap him up and slam him into the ground. You rush in and grapple with Sigbjorn, both of you fighting for an advantage. Everyone else moves back, giving you two a wide berth. When you finally get a hold and throw him to the ground, he rolls, grabs a pot of boiling soup and mops it at you. You bat the pot away, but the liquid splashes you and grow in pain. Sigbjorn's face drops as he sees the rage in your eyes. The berserker recovers the distance with two steps, not preparing during your axes. They slash fiercely, wildly, repeatedly. There is one less foul in the world. Everyone else stays well away from you until Volca signals that your fury has passed. Even then, the ravens are cautious as they strip Sigbjorn's body of valuables and prepare his pyre. That was not my intention.
Volca Zephyr is speaking quietly to Volca when you approach. Not forbidden in the earth of Volca to help children. So Nicholas was like a son. He was not my child by birth.
What did you do to him back in that cave?
I did the only thing I could do. The thing we never want to do. The Volca's eyes fill with tears. I forced a skip in the pattern. It won't mean much to you. Suffice it is to say that menders usually repair skips or mistakes in the woven fabric of our world. They cover powerful exposed threads until all is right, and the pattern is whole.
I did just the opposite. I stared at her blankly. By skipping Nichols, I exposed a threat and used that power to end Alice's attack. And that cost Nichols his life. Yes, but it is a sacrifice every mender is prepared to make. Will it be necessary?
How do I know you won't try to skip me when we get to Manhor?
Because I can't. It is a conscious choice a mender is taught how to make. Silence pauses a few moments. A brave kid, then.
The ravens will remember him in a battle chant.
I'm sure he would have liked that. Was there anything else you wanted to discuss?
Any idea what Golor would abandon its prisoners?
I've been out of contact with the council since I departed for Brindle, but it can be good. If the prisoners were telling the truth about everyone fleeing to Arborang, King Maynul will have a serious problem to handle. I wonder if Rook and the others know what they're heading into.
They're not our concern. Enough talking, let's get moving.
Agreed. We need to get this card to Manahar soon, and we're not far now.
And I have hiccups.
Okay, we don't even need to rest. So let's see. These woodcutters were no slouches in a fight with these prisoners, Sparks says coughing. I've seen weaker men in war them, and I think this group realizes their idea of staying here is a pretty bad one. You want me to recruit them?
More fighters always good, but what's the downside?
Same as it always been. They eat like blasted trolls, but can't find food to save their lives. Our supplies will go quicker.
We'll risk it. Recruit them.
I've got a suspicion you actually like humans more than anyone of our lives. Sparks is chuckling under the stars, coughing and over and wheezing for air.
A large group of the clansmen from Bindal have stopped, gasping in whispers among them. What's the problem now? You ask, breaking into that circle and finding a couple protectively holding a vulnerable baby.
It's a curse! An omen! The old man says. The child's been replaced. Changed! Never seen anything like it. You wouldn't know a thing about this world, but they do!
Points at the couple and others now. A few women holding their children tighter.
Maybe the darkness did it. Maybe they have dark secrets. It's a sad, hard thing to accept. But either the baby dies or we all suffer fiercely. Show me the kid.
The father hesitates before pulling the swaddlings open. Your experience with human children is minimal, but this looks just like any other baby.
Look at the head! Someone shouts.
Lean down and see. Feathers? Over the years, small tufts of pale down feathers. The kind you remember seeing on the neck and under the wings of Erinix.
If it's an omen, it's a good one. No one harms the child.
The mother starts weeping and thanking you. Little Hrknor. Rukr, he mumbled, and the father smiles.
That's what I call him,
he says. Maybe the gods aren't. He walk off before he's finished.
The fighters at the front of the company begin hacking away at this underbrush. We'll be here all day if the rest of you don't grab your axes and start chopping. One of them growls before wincing in pain in his hand.
As he says, everyone grab an axe!
You breathe and threaten anyone not chopping through the dense foliage. The fibrous vines and sticky leaves soon fill the air. Everyone is covered in plant matter. Everyone but Ollie, who is standing at a distance from axes and vines ineffectively.
Volga's cry of agony is uncommon enough to draw attention. Others start cringing and yelping too. Knock it!
Before you can finish shouting, a burning, stinging pain tears through your arms and eyes and nose.
I think that's the plan is poison, Ollie says before taking another drink.
He feels around in his pouch and pulls out some brown, wet leaves.
Here, these are called... No, counts. These counters. These make the poison go away.
Pain ripples through again, making you want to burn it.
Grab the leaves and eat them. What are they?
Brutal. No.
Patrol has opened its own and leaves you for all of shaking. When you finally open your eyes, you feel heavy and horrible. Your crowd and the rest of the company looks as bad as you feel. Took me time to get to everyone. And he says, searching a card for something to drink. You might need more sleep to be right again.
Respected Picklider the Builder. But if he made those caves we went through, I'd have killed him myself.
You nice, watch your step around this jet, Kairns, Spar says, hacking. Many a foolish pilgrim have given their life at the base of this frozen cliff. And don't try walking one of the stones free either, or you'll bring the whole damn thing down on us. He laughs at Ollie, who pulls his hand away from the stone quickly. The pieces of big layers, godstone, put together without mortar or doubt, represent the mastery of the god's own skill. In life, he traveled the land, laying the world's cavernous foundation and rising mountains. He was ever regarded by the other gods with a very respect, for one who knows how to put things together will also know how to take them apart. The sound of sintering draws your attention, and you see some kids grabbing souls from the other parents with a new one on the own. Drop a stone and toss it to them, you add. The stone you pick is bigger than anything they are using, but they are amazed that you contributed. The kids find a way to support its way on top of all of theirs, laughing and chasing each other away when it's all finished. An uneasy feeling washes over you and you scan the raven's clansmen in Belovus' card for any threat. Blood axe, Sparrow says in a tone strip of all humor. My eyes are too old to trust what I'm seeing down there, through his gaze and growl. On the distant fields below is a mass of dredge, too numerous to count. Waves of them are pouring over hills, though they don't move like an attacking force. There's a banner among them. Oh, there's a banner among them, Volga says near you. But I can't make out the crest. You wave off her command and roar command. You wave off her comment and roar command. Move. The edge are pouring over those hills like ants. Several ravens report a large hole in the ground nearby. There's strange marks all around it, one says. Some look fresh, others look like they've been there as long as the mountains, Bar looks up. This hole have smooth sides? About as deep as a wall? He asks the mid-millions of friends. What's in the hole? We couldn't tell, Scout says. No trees around, just a deep hole in the ground about the 4 yokes length across. My arms were like chicken skin, just looking at it. Let's have a look at this. You craven. No sooner has the word left your mouth than you see Volkar look at you. Are you trying to be funny? Craven and raven? Ignore her and head for the hole. It's as described. Big, deep, surrounded by stones in the surrounding rock and disturbing. Let's move on. No more surprises. Everyone looks relieved moving away from the strange oppression on the ground. The company comes upon a small village. The people still hard at work with only an occasional glance skyward to the approaching darkness. Volka sees a man chopping wood as she learned to do a lifetime ago. These people don't know what's coming. They'll figure it out soon enough, you say, entering the rest of the cavern. We get what we need from this place and rest if necessary. The next few days will be the hardest and the last some of you will ever see.
Pokka gives you a look and you snort. As you instruct a man to take the cartwheels and yoke straps, you hear someone say, hello again? You turn quickly and see the man ditched, quiet as always, but wisely out of your immediate axe reach. What do you want? Well, just as I was scouting around the space, you know, it says, and I went up on a hill towards the dredge. The banner we saw is from Einartoft. Einartoft. The grimace as the town's name floods your mind with images. A giant bridge, hundreds of barrels, either in your way, your anger focused just beyond him. Einartoft was sacked, the old war leader, Krummer, says. You'd better be as sure as traps things about what you saw, human. Dismiss quickly, then I'm going after them. Krum says it's not a request. Let the old war kill himself if he wants. But he'll die. Oh, join him. Stick with him, it will to the few fighters you'll all join. If he's still as lucky as he claims, we'll grab the others and get back in one piece. Because we'll help him. Okay, might be suicidal, we won't leave him alone. Yep. So, I think we're going to need that. Let's take Ditch. Since I learned about how he fights, it's nice. It goes in a whole lot easier. Do we have any 6? No. Yeah, I think we should take her up. Okay. This is suicidal. This is first. Okay? No. This is the guy. Ooh. It's my part. I can't get it there. Let's go straight to this. Block the other one. Yeah, I'm gonna bank on him. Raise on him. Let's hide. Fast. Let's get rid of this guy. Of course. Mm-hmm. It's all good. He has 11 defense, but it's just nothing for them. Weak with your man. Let's go for more. Well, he's injured but not dead.
The mangled appearance of a varl stands in front of you long enough to shout. You want to stare at me or get out of this fair mess? He and the other varl fighters flow past you with all the strength they have left, knocking away any dredge that get too close. Once back in the village, the deep tones of the Scarbrow utter curses you've never heard before. Then he sees you. You the final leader of these pathetic humans? The Shulbanger will ask you. These humans are the Ravens, you say. And I'm Bill. I'm Bolverk. Who are you and why do you look like you were spit out of a cold by a cold bear? The Brow stares at you and then cracks what might be a smile beneath all the facial wounds. Fasold, former commander of what was Aenapo. You might recognize this one beside me. You ask the Vrow, not really any horns or bear. Kvig? You ask. What in the depths? Kvig is there as well. The last one made. We're all what's left of those who fled Grofheim and stood against Belwer at Einarthof, she says. Kvig, run out, run and get us some damn drinks and some meat. Bolverk and I need to go. I always figured the ravens were a myth. Overall, always being around so many humans doesn't make any sense. I needed fighters, and there's a lot more humans to choose from these days. The skull lifts Fussel's face for the first time, a distant look in his eyes. I'm alive by luck alone. No skill of a weapon or desire to kill could have seen me through that. Einarthoft was a massacre. Fussel grows quiet. What happened back there? More death than I've ever seen in all my centuries combined. Belwer led an incredible force against us with such precision. He moved his horse of fighters around like his own arms and legs. And if we friend cut one off, he just grew another. Why do you feel proud? Why didn't you more of you flee? Jörg decided to make a stand. I was left for dead. Woke up to a cruel raven pecking my face. They near got my eyes. Fussel grows quiet. How did you make it through the fields of the Dredge? This stuff behind us? Very easy, those aren't old Dredge warriors. They might all be armed, but they're mostly families. Most won't bother you if you leave them alone. Since when have Dredge ever left us alone? They'll still kill you if you stick your ass on the ground for too long, but I'm telling you what I've seen. Most of those stone bastards seem to be running scared. Most seem to be a number of them hunting something or someone though. Fussel grows quiet. Stick with us and you can get some revenge. What makes you think I'm interested in anything like that? He holds your stare for a moment before laughing an unexpected cruel laugh. The truth is I could kill 100 of the slugs a day and not be fulfilled. There's more dredge than rats, and after Grofheim and Einarthoft, the Varl are done. The Battle of Borsgard was a bloodbath too. Oh, what happened? The ravens cobbled in to keep people from rioting. Trying to get those people to leave was useless. Then Belwer showed up with an army. A human took him down. A human? The immortal Belwer is dead? This question makes it tense, though you're unclear why. Wait, which human? A girl, daughter of a hunter named Nuruk, shot the center of some sort of vaca. The Varl's demeanor changes, it's growling. Is Nuruk still alive? Last I knew, he was leading the group to Arbor. Why? Because I've come all this way with a fan message for him from our former king. Fussel's eyes, accented by the torn skin, look deadly. If you're heading west, I'll stay with you to the old fort. You have more questions, but decide to leave about with brooding thoughts. And this is where we're going to end this part because some damn neighbor is starting drilling. So for now, thank you very much. Stay alive and see you soon. Bye!